All right, so welcome back. In the previous video, we set up our game mode and assigned our default Pong class so that we could use our character blueprint as the playable character in our level. In this video, we are going to finish off setting up our character blueprint by allowing the gamepad right thumbstick to control the camera, as well as setting up our touch controls. Now, I kind of want to illustrate something here really quickly before we continue. Let me move my project settings up to the top up here in Docket, and then let me play in the editor. So right now, if you had a gamepad connected, you could use your left thumbstick to kind of move around. However, if you tried to use your right thumbstick to control the camera, you currently couldn't do that, as we have not set that input up as well. But I also wanted to mention using the left thumbstick as the example to move our character. If I hit Escape and I go back to our project settings, there is our gamepad left thumbstick y-axis and game left thumbstick x-axis. That's a mouthful. You can see those under our move forward and move right events. Now, I kind of wanted to point this out. If I scroll down below all of our bindings here and I go down to the mobile section, there's an option for default touch interface. You can see it's currently using the default virtual joysticks. This actually resides inside the engine mobile resources folder, which is part of the engine content that comes standard with Unreal Engine 4. So if I hit the magnifying glass here, that will allow me to browse to that asset in the content browser. So if I click that, there is that asset inside the content browser. And you can kind of see that it has exposed our engine folder, which you can go to the view options down here in the lower right. You can show or hide that. It's hidden by default. Just wanted to point that out really quickly. But all of these assets inside the engine folder are things that are used by the engine. Typically, you won't have to mess with them, but it's good to know that they are there. Specifically, in this instance, the default virtual joysticks. If I double click on that to open it, you can see there's a section for controls. Now, the 0 and 1, this represents the left thumbstick, and this represents the right thumbstick. If I expand these, and under zero, if I scroll down, there's a section for main input key. And look what's assigned to it, the gamepad left thumbstick X axis. So we've already set this up for the main and alt input keys. We've already set these up to use our move forward event for that gamepad left thumbstick. So what this is essentially meaning, long story short, is that the touch interface for us for movement is already set up, as well as controlling the camera with our right thumbstick, which we'll set up in a moment. Those are already set up by default because we've already defined it with our gamepad control. So there's not a lot that we need to do for our touch setup. So let's close this. We're not going to be changing anything in here. Just kind of wanted to show that really quickly. And let's also hide our engine content again because we're not going to be touching anything inside engine content. And let's begin working on our character blueprint with the final controls that we need. So inside character, let's open character BP. Let's open it up. And let's see, the first thing that we're gonna do, let's drag somewhere so we have some space to work. We're gonna right click and we're gonna search for turn rate or turn, either one. And there's our axis event and our axis values. Again, we want the axis event. So let's grab our turn rate. Maybe mouse wheel in to zoom in a little bit. Let's also add our lookup rate while we're at it. So right click, search for lookup rate, and use our axis event there. Now what we're going to do is take our axis values that we get from our turn rate and lookup rate, and we're going to multiply that by a couple different things. The first thing we're going to multiply that by is the delta time in seconds, or how much time has occurred between frames. This will give us a smooth turn. And then we also want to multiply that by a variable that we can control to kind of adjust how much we turn, how quickly we turn or look up. So let's do that. Let's drag off the axis value here, left click and drag off, and search for multiply. We want float by float. You can see it's only giving us two pins. We can add additional pins if we'd like. So let's add a third pin. And for this first one, to get the delta time in seconds, there's a function for that. We can right click and search for get world delta seconds. So there it is, get world delta seconds. like so. And let's plug that in, like so. And for this last one, we're going to right-click on this last pin here and promote that to a variable. And let's move it down so it's not hidden. And over in the details panel for this variable, let's rename it. Let's call this the base turn rate. Now, we also want to make this editable so that we can edit it inside the level editor like we've done with our invert mouse control here. So let's make it editable. Let's give it a tooltip. Let's call it the amount to turn, or let's actually call it the default amount to turn. I think that's a good enough tooltip. And then we need to compile because we actually need to set a default value. So it says, please compile the blueprint. So let's go ahead and do that since it's asking so politely. Compile. Now we can set that base turn rate. See, it's currently set to 0. We're going to start out at about 200. Again, you can modify these values however you'd like. That's just one that I have experimented with and have found that works for me. So we're good. Let's go ahead and add the controller yaw input now. So we're going to right click, add controller yaw input. And let's connect our executable out here to our executable in, and the float out to the value in. So we've done our yaw input. The pitch is going to be pretty much identical to this, except we're going to be adding the pitch input. So let's right click and add controller pitch. Controller pitch input. So. And we can get our world delta seconds again, and we can hold control and select our multiply node here, hit control C and control V. And we can connect everything up like we have done up here. Let's grab our axis values, our axis value, and plug that into the multiply. Let's connect our executable here to the executable in. And let's connect our out result here to the in on our pitch input. Now for the third pin, we need to create another variable because we don't want to use the same variable as our base turn rate, obviously. So let's right click on this pin here and promote to variable. And let's call this the base look up rate. Gonna move that down just a little bit so we can see it. Let's go up to the details panel, make it editable, and the tooltip, the default amount to look up. And let's hit compile to compile the blueprint. And let's assign our base lookup rate default value. We'll set that to 200 as well. Okay. We are done with our lookup and turn rate. So let's add a comment around all of this. I'll click and drag and hit C. And this is the gamepad controls for the camera. So let's compile and save. And let's test this actually. Now, hopefully you have a gamepad plugged in that you can try this out with as well. If not, in a moment, we will get to the touch controls. You can see this working inside the touch control. Unfortunately for us, Unreal provides a sample interface that will allow us to kind of touch or test touch controls on the PC here. So I'm gonna go over to our level editor viewport here. And let's move out. And inside the details panel with our character in our level selected, you can see there are our default values that we can adjust now if we want to change those values to anything. So I'm going to play in the editor here. And inside the editor, let me make sure that we have control. So okay, that's my mouse. And now on my joystick, if I move to the right, I move to the right. And if I move to the left, I move to the left. And I can look up and down, as well as using the left stick to kind of move around in the level as well. So our setup is good. The next thing that we need to do is provide our touch commands. Fortunately for us, the touch commands for movement and controlling the camera are already done. We do need to provide touch commands for jumping, because right now we have no way of jumping for a touch command. So let's go ahead and set that up, and we'll also test that inside the editor here as well. So to do that, back in the character blueprint here, let's go back to the character blueprint. And I'm going to right-click and drag our graph over a little bit. Zoom out. Let's do it over here somewhere. So for this, let's right-click, and let's search for input touch. So let's search for input touch. Touch, that's what we want, is just touch. So select the touch node. Again, I think I kind of went by too fast. If you didn't see it, just search for touch. Touch. There it is. Touch is what you want, this option here. So event when for when a finger presses, releases, or is moved on a touch device. That's the one we want. Now, the thing that we need to check, however, is with touch devices, you could have multiple fingers on a device at once. So what we want to do is determine whenever one finger touches the device, whenever the first finger touches the device, that's when we want the character to jump. So we don't want the character to jump if the player is touching it with multiple fingers. So to do that, we can use this finger index here. This is what tells us how many fingers are touching the device. So we can drag off of this, and we can search for equals. So hit two equal signs. And then down at the bottom, there's an enumerator. So if I select this enumerator, it's going to give us the options for up to 10 fingers touching the device. We want to leave it on one. So whenever the first finger touches the device, it's going to give us a true or false, which we can hold B and left click to create a branch. And we can connect our condition here, like so. And off the pressed, we can left click, drag that into the branch. And off of our true, we can jump. So let's search for jump, like so. There we go. Let's add a comment around this. And press C. And this is touch jump. Like so. And let's compile and save. Now let's test this inside the mobile template preview. So we can do that. We can do that from actually inside the blueprint editor here. There's an option for the drop down here. If we click this little drop down option here, currently we are playing in the selected viewport, but right below that, there is a mobile preview option. Go ahead and select that. And it's going to take a second to actually load that up because it's got to load that externally. It's actually popping off screen, so I'm going to have to drag that in here in a second. It's popping off screen, so give it a second to load off screen. I probably should have tested this beforehand, but just a second. And now let me drag it in. Come on. There we go. So it says that lighting needs to be rebuilt, shading needs to be rebuilt, etc. Because I didn't build lighting or do any of that yet. But inside of our game here, we have two virtual joysticks that I can use to kind of move our character around. I could also simulate touching the device by clicking outside of those joysticks. And let me hold Shift and F1 really quickly to get my mouse back. Now, if I use the right stick, I can control our camera now. So we are done. We have set up touch controls. We can jump on a mobile device. We can use the virtual joysticks to control on a mobile device. We've also can use the right thumbstick on a gamepad to control our camera now. Our character is pretty much playable at this point. In the next video, we will take our player control to another level by adding some punches. So we'll set that up in the next video. Actually, first, before we do that, I kind of want to talk about animation montages and punching. So we'll do that first before we actually go in and start building our animation montage for punching. So in the next video, we will talk about animation montages and begin talking about how we're going to construct our punching sequence. Thank you guys for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next video.